If you're here to learn how to design an electrical control panel in under 10 minutes, then you've clicked on the right video,
because I'm going to show you the exact steps that I take when designing initial layout designs for any electrical control system. And that's what's great about this method. It can be applied across lots of different types of systems across all different types of industries. And I've used this method for industrial controls and instrumentation, smart home automation, and as you'll see in this video, BMS and building energy management projects too. And just to mention before we get into this video, this is part of a module taken from my new training program, Control System Specialist, of which you can find more information in the description. Hey guys, now we're at a stage where we can start designing the internal panel layout and then get an idea of the size of enclosure that we need to order. And the first thing I want you to take a look at is this panel layout parts, which is like a big bin of all the hardware I've used for BMS systems over the last couple of years. And what I've done is I've drawn out the block size for all of these different components, and doing this just saves time. I don't have to draw them out manually every time. I can just copy and paste straight from this bin. So the process that I would follow for each page would be to basically just go through it and see what parts are actually physically going into the panel and mounted to the backplate. So the first thing would be this door isolator. Next, we've got this transformer. Then we've got the laptop socket. And then of course, we've got MCBs and relays as well. So let's take that page to start with. And if you take a look down here, I've already copy and pasted from that bin all the components that are relevant for this project. So the first one is this, that's the door isolator. Come back to the transformer. We've got our laptop socket, which is here. We've got our MCBs and we've got our relays, and our relays are two pole. We've got a two pole relay base here, and we've got MCB single pole here. Now, I haven't got a transformer at the moment, so how do I go about adding a transformer? So it's very simple, guys. Find the tech manual for that transformer that you're going to use, and that tech manual can be found in the tech manual folder, panel components, and it's PS-160. So let's open that up. And the one that we're after is the PS-25, and it basically just gives us the dimensions here. So the dimensions I'm after is G and A, so 77 and 68. So I'd go back into CAD and I'd hit the rectangle button. I'd click on the screen. I'd type in D for dimension, enter, and then I'd add the first dimension, which is the horizontal, which is A, so that's 77. Hit enter, and then the vertical dimension, which is 68, and then click the left mouse button. And that's our transformer. Okay, so that's everything drawn out in blocks and in the right scale and dimensions for page one. And then what I'd do is just work my way through the drawing, adding any additional components that we haven't added already until I get to the end. Simple as that. Obviously, things like relays and MCBs, they've already been added, so I don't have to add extra ones each time. What we're doing in a minute is we're just copy and paste the amount of those that we need and lay them out sort of next to each other. Now, because for this one we're just going with the standard block layout, I'm just going to quickly draw over this motor starter just to get the box size. There we go. So that's that copied. This is also going to have a contactor on the bottom of it, so let's go and find that. There we go, mini contactor. Copy this, move it over here, select it again, M, move, and then I'll just move it like that. There we go. So that will look something like this. And then it's just a matter of naming it as it is. Okay, moving on to the MCBs and the relays. So let's open up our schedule for that. So we know that we've got 14 MCBs and they're all single poles. Okay, so let's find our MCB. Let's copy and paste that. So C, select that corner. And then we're just going to run through this 14 times. And then I'm going to add a few blanks on the end for spares as well. Okay, so that's all the 14 MCBs. So I'll put that on there. And then let's highlight those, make them pink, just so we know they're blanks. And we put that there too. Cool, so I can remove that single MCB. That's all our MCBs. Now onto the two-pole relay bases, or the two-pole relays. So let's open up our schedule again, the relays tab, and there's 33 of them. We haven't actually got any four-pole relays, so I'll remove that. Let's copy this. And it's the same thing again. We'll just copy that 33 times. Okay, so that's 33. Let's copy that, move that over here, and we can delete that single relay. Now, there is a quicker way of doing that, guys, but unless you know how to use it, it's usually not quicker, certainly if you're just doing like 10 to 20. But if you're doing lots of terminal blocks when it comes to like 60, 70 units, the function that I'd point you to is this array function here. So you can basically draw one block, click array, and then you can work out what the offsets are, and then it will duplicate that however many times you've told it to duplicate it. So that's just a quicker way of doing what we've just done. So I think that's everything now, guys, apart from the terminal blocks, which we're going to come back to. That is all our components within the panel worked out. So now we need to start thinking about how all those components look as they would be arranged in an enclosure. So if you take a look over here.
Quick one, if you're finding this video helpful, can you just tap that like button? Really help us out and I'd really appreciate it.
The two enclosures that I've worked with most for BMS systems over the last couple of years are the same sized enclosure in a horizontal format or vertical format. So either 800 by 1200 or 1200 by 800. So for a project this size, that's the enclosure that I'm going to start with. And if I need to spec up from there, I can, or if I need to downsize it, then I can. But it's just really to get an idea of how the components look within that size enclosure. So I'm going to use the horizontal and I'm going to copy that over here. I'm going to grab a piece of DIN rail and I'm going to start working my way from the top or the bottom, depending if it's top or bottom cable entry, and just sort of work out how things look, taking into account like spacings of trunking, DIN rail, and enough space so you can get your fingers in between the trunking and the modules to actually get the cables into the modules. And this panel is going to be a top cable entry. So I'm going to start with the terminal blocks at the top. There's going to be a bit of trunking along the top row as well. So I reckon terminals are going to start about here because I don't know how many I need at the moment. I'm just going to go rectangle, move that across, something like that. And then for the spacing between components and trunking, I try and keep a space of around 25 to 35 millimeters. So there's enough room to get your finger and thumb in there to do the wiring. So I'll click there, I'll type 35 and I'll highlight that in red. So the next thing here, there'd be a bit of trunking. So let's have a look what we got over here. Let's go with the 60 by 80 to start with. Copy that and let's rotate it. Let's make that blue. I'm also gonna just add a center line through the terminal blocks here. Let's copy our spacer again. Then we're gonna put the MCBs in, see what that looks like here. Another bit of trunking. Now our relays, put a spacer in there quickly. I'll add a bit of trunking at the top and the bottom as well. Okay, and I've just extended the center lines of the DIN rail. So looking at that now, I'm pretty confident that all of those components are gonna fit in there. Now it doesn't have to be spaced perfectly and in a logical order at the moment, but it's just to try and get an idea that that control panel is gonna be the right size. So I'll quickly add that all now and then we'll come back to assess what it looks like. Okay, and then the final bits, guys, are just some WAGO distribution blocks. And let's put these there for now. But yeah, as you can see, I think that size panel is a good size for all of those components. They're not all cramped in. There's not loads of space, but there's some space for expansion, which we definitely want to include. So yeah, I think that enclosure size is good as a starting point. What you've got to remember though, is that's the outside enclosure size. That's not the internal backplate, which we're gonna be mounting everything to. That internal backplate is actually smaller. So that's just something to consider at this stage when you're working everything out. But like I said, that's plenty of room. We'll fit on the smaller backplate as well, so happy with that. And what you'll tend to find on larger, higher end panels, they tend to split the panel into two sections. So they have a panel for the power, and then they have a panel for the controls or the BMS. Ultimately, what's holding the electronics, like the PLC modules. Now on this panel, I don't think it's necessary to do that, but when we move forward onto the next stage, and I spend a little bit more time spacing everything out and making it look a lot nicer and neater and putting it into a logical order, it might be that I arrange it to match that power on the left and the controls on the right. Okay guys, so that's the first section done of the panel layout, just covering the component sizing and getting them roughly put into an enclosure just to make sure we're on the right tracks. The next section, section two, we're going to start looking at sizing the trunking correctly.
Now, if you wanted to learn more about the whole process involved with designing and building control systems, then control system specialist will 100% help you with that. And if you'd like to see an electrical control panel being wired in under 10 minutes, then I think you'll really like this video here.